Hi, I'm Greg Tito.
And I'm Alina Koch with your guide to this week's hottest news.
This is the Escapist News Wrap. I have some sad news to start out this week. More and more parents are naming their tiny babies after computer products. In BabyCenter.com's annual report, one of the most troubling trends uncovered in 2012 is a 15% increase in Apple as a name for baby girls. Also on the rise was Mac for boys, with 12% growth over last year, as well as 5% more parents choosing Siri for girls. I guess that means parents want their daughters to never understand what the hell they're saying.
Irrational Games loved a Russian cosplayer so much it hired her to be the official face of BioShock Infinite's Elizabeth. Anna Moleva, who goes by the handle Ormeli on her DeviantArt page, has a striking resemblance to the character once Irrational finally settled on her look. Moleva couldn't resist trying to nail the costume and look of Elizabeth and released some amazing pictures of her work last year. The creative team at Irrational took notice and decided to embrace the cosplayer's efforts, hiring her to appear as Elizabeth on the box art for the game and attend conventions and events dressed as the character. Let that be a lesson to all you cosplayers out there. Sometimes dreams do come true.
Microsoft won a legal battle to keep the Xbox 360 from being banned in the United States. The mobile phone company Motorola claimed Microsoft violated its patents involving video codecs and Wi-Fi connectivity. But a U.S. judge ruled the patents should be licensed on fair and reasonable terms. Of course, the two companies dispute what exactly is fair and or reasonable, with Motorola asking for $4 billion a year and Microsoft offering to pay only $1 million. The judge went on to reprimand the two companies for using such court cases as negotiation techniques and that, quote, it has been arbitrary, it has been arrogant, and frankly, it has been based on hubris. Ouch. Take it easy, judge. We're only talking about billions of dollars here.
You better not be cheating in Planetside 2, or John Smedley will come to your house and beat you up. The Sony Online Entertainment president takes hackers and aimbot users very seriously, and he took to Twitter to update the community on the crackdown in the recently released MMO FPS. Smedley said there are staffers at SOE dedicated to finding cheaters and banning them. He called out one hacker in particular, the guy behind artificialaiming.com, saying, quote, goodbye, scumbag. Find a new hobby or get good at the game. Smedley didn't even flinch when people pointed out the banned parties could just start a new account and saying, quote, use it, we'll find you, we'll find your family, we'll hunt you down. Is it just me or is he doing a bad impression of Liam Neeson in Taken?
In yet another story about bad behavior, Riot Games permanently banned a professional player from competing in the League of Legends World Championship Series. The player known as I Will Dominate consistently abused his competitors and regularly engaged in unsportsmanlike conduct while playing. It's not like he didn't get any warnings that such a ban was incoming. I Will Dominate had been punished 8 times prior to this permanent ban for his, quote, persistent toxic behavior. The professional player took the ban in stride, acknowledging the punishment was tough, but that he supported Riot in fostering an atmosphere of sportsmanship. It only took 8 punishments and a permanent ban to learn your lesson, dude. Well, let's hope you grow up soon and learn to follow the summoner's code.
The United States Congress voted to unilaterally oppose the United Nations efforts to control the internet. The UN's proposed International Telecommunications Union Treaty would have allowed for governments to control the free flow of information on the net. And for once, Republicans and Democrats, senators and congressmen, presidents and even janitors unanimously voted to block the resolution. One Republican representative said, quote, we need to send a strong message to the world that the internet has thrived under a decentralized, bottom-up, multi-stakeholder governance model. Or in other words, stay off our web. We need to keep those cat videos flowing.
Have you ever wished for your significant other to smell like pizza? Me neither. Well, a lucky few fans of the American chain Pizza Hut will be able to entice their hungry companions by spraying their naughty bits with a perfume called Eau de Pizza Hut. The marketing geniuses behind this prank hired a perfumer to craft a fragrance which apparently smells close to freshly baked bread. The first 100 people who responded to the official Pizza Hut Twitter announcing this olfactory tragedy will receive bottles of this scent, while the restaurant is holding back the final 10 bottles for private distribution. Elena, what is that alluring scent you're wearing? Did you get one of the perfume bottles?
Oh no, that's Chanel's new macaroni and cheese number 5. Mm. That's your news wrap for this week.
Stay tuned to escapistmagazine.com for all the latest news.